Have you ever wondered what happens in a lateral flow testing facility for COVID-19? We'll show you what happens inside our school testing, and also we'll give you an idea as to what to expect, so when students come back, they'll be very aware of how to proceed safely whilst we keep them safe on site. Hi, I'm Dave Hemsley. I'm the Assistant Head Teacher at the University of Liverpool Math School. I'm going to tell you a little bit about our testing site and what to expect when students come back. So the main thing is all schools in the country were given the testing facility to allow them to keep people safe on site by looking for people who are asymptomatic, and as a result of that, allowing them to stay at home, and any close contacts could potentially have a test for 7 days. Now, the guidance has changed on that recently, so that's not something that's currently happening, but we are offering staff the opportunity to have a test twice a week if they are on site with us. So I'm just going to talk you through a little bit about the process so you can see what it's like here and also how it works, because you might actually be interested in what it means with the lateral flow device. So we've taken one of our physics labs and turned this into our coronavirus test centre. So upon arrival, you'll get one of these registration cards, and it comes with 3 barcodes, but we'll talk about that in a moment. We've got our own site ID, and we've set it up as outlined by the guidance from the NHS. So we have our places where you'll do your self-swabbing. There's very clear instructions how to do that, which we'll come back to a little bit later. But the whole area is going to be cleaned after every single test, so it's always going to be fresh and clean for you on arrival. We've got a capacity to do 2 at once, so for our school size, that's absolutely fine. So we should be able to get through everyone on site basically within a couple of hours for the days that we might need to do this. Okay, behind the place where you do the swabbing is the areas where you prepare for the test to be ready for the swabbed cotton to go into, which we'll talk about a little bit later. But also as well here, you've got all the guidance and everything for the people doing the testing on the wall, so it's all nice and clear as good reminders. And also we've got all the PPE that's needed available, and all the guidance as well for PPE, how to put it on, how to remove it, and which person in which role needs to wear what as well, which is always good to have a reminder. So it's important to get the PPE on at the start, and that does have to be changed quite regularly depending on the role you're in. So it's all very clean, all very hygienic, and the idea is to reduce the chances of cross-contamination. So upon arrival, you'll be greeted by somebody who'll give you the registration card, and they'll give you 3 barcodes. Now you put one of these barcodes onto the registration card, and then what you use is that is basically you to register your test. So basically you get the results go in and you get it back. So what you do is you scan the little QR code and it takes you straight to the place where you can register. Okay, you can sign up using your NHS login, or you can do it without, it doesn't really matter, but then it asks you to enter your barcode. So this is unique to you, and you can actually scan the barcode that's on the little sheet, and that is then going to be following you through this whole testing process, including the result as well, which I'll show you a little bit later. So you scan your barcode and then you get registered. You'll be given some advice in terms of how to actually do the test, so someone will be on hand for that at all times. And whilst you're getting ready, basically the liquid that we use as part of the test, that'll be put into one of these small plastic test tubes. So we put 6 drops into here. Now this is the solution into which your swab after you've done the self-test will go. So we have 6 drops of that, and that is obviously kept on the clean desk, which again is wiped after every single test. Okay, so it's all the highest cleaning standards. You can see here the operator will be changing gloves at the end of every session, for example. Okay, so the swab is then opened up, so that swab can be handed to the person doing the self-swabbing. They don't touch the cotton at the other side, so it's just handed to them. They can give you the barcodes, and they take the swab out, and they will do that, which we'll talk about in a second. Okay, so with the barcodes clearly there, so they're handed over, that will be going with your test. So you scanned it in to register you as that person. That barcode will then be used to scan your test to get your result to you later. So when you come into the booth, you'll be asked to blow your nose, and when you've blown your nose, you'll be asked to sanitize your hands. So you take the actual swab, okay, and say while the person is doing their swabbing, you can see the barcodes are going onto the back of the cartridges where you will essentially get your test done. Okay, so that is the little device that does the test. There's no machinery involved. It's very much like a pregnancy test in terms of using liquid and looking for a change in colour on the actual cartridge, which we'll talk to you about that later. Okay, so the 6 little drops of liquid are waiting in that small little test tube. And the swabbing process, basically what you need to do is you basically turn it about 4 times on each side of the back of the mouth, basically where the tonsils are, either side of the mouth. And then what you need to do is insert it about 2.5 centimeters up the nose until you meet some resistance. And again, you turn it for around about 10 seconds up one nostril. Any nose piercings, things like that, you don't use that nostril. Okay, and then when that's done, you who self-swabbed it will return that back into the little test tube. And then that is going to be used to generate the solution that is going to be tested. So all that happens is your swabbed sample will be definitely made sure that it has dissolved into the liquid, any chemicals that are vital for the testing process. So you spend about 10 seconds turning that round inside the little plastic container. And then what you do is you squeeze it at the bottom and you pull out the swab. So hopefully anything on there is into the liquid. That obviously gets put into the correct bin. There's different bins for different things, and all of which are disposed following all the guidance as well. So now you've got this little liquid and you put a little lid on so you can actually put a couple of drops into your test cartridge. Okay, so the 2 little drops go into there, making sure there's no air bubbles. So once those 2 drops go in there, it actually then gets absorbed up the little piece of paper that's inside, and it'll move up the cartridge, which I'll show you what the positive and the negative tests look like in a bit. So the important thing is to make sure the time is marked on there as well, because you have to be sure to check that within 30 minutes. Anything beyond 30 minutes, you might possibly get a false positive. So the time is quite an important thing to record. Now that cartridge then is taken and put into a tray, and we do minimize movement with that to make sure there's nothing peculiar happening to that test. So that will sit there now, and if you have a little look, you can see the liquid has started to move up towards the letter C. So that liquid is getting absorbed, it is going where it should do, and you'll be able to see what that result looks like a little bit later. So this is sometime later, so half an hour passed. Okay, if it's a negative result, then you can write a minus on it, and that is there then for the person to record the actual result. So the idea is you can get quite a few of these tests done through, say, an hour and a half or so. So people will be able to come in and things can be prepared and ready. So these are the results. Okay, so basically you're looking for a negative, hopefully. It's just one line across at C, okay, the control line. So if you have a little look, this one here has got one line across at C. So that one is a negative result. Okay, if it happened to have 2 lines, one at T as well, then that would be a positive result. Okay, so that one's negative with the barcode again. You scan that and then the results will get sent straight back to that person. So that'll go through email and it'll go through test and trace. So you'll get back your results within half an hour as soon as it's scanned. And also that same result goes to test and trace. And test and trace, if need be, if it's positive, can then get back in touch with you and can get back in touch with the school, and we can do the right things following the guidance at the time. Okay, so as I say, these things are in place to allow schools to try and spot asymptomatic COVID carriers. So ones who don't exhibit any symptoms but potentially could be spreading it. So the hope was to use this in the new year when schools went back, which we did use for staff as instructed. And again, we're still using that for staff now. But the hope is when schools do reopen, this facility will be used for students when needed, probably on their return, and if need be, during any, if they've been a close contact, to allow them to stay in school. Because that was the original idea, to try and keep people in school so they don't have to self-isolate and just check they never show a positive test for COVID-19. Okay, so that's the end of the whole process. So if you'd like to find out any more, obviously the NHS websites can tell you a lot about these sorts of things. And equally, if you've got any questions for us about coming back to school, then please do get in touch. But stay safe, look after yourselves, and all the best.